killed himself, he did. This is like a Viking helm. Did they abduct like a Viking and just bring him here? Dang, okay. Hey guys, welcome back to After Work Gaming. We are here in the Solus Project, and we are actually back in the Passage of the Travelers. Now, why are we back here? Well, because remember, there's this weak wall, and last time we picked up a hammer. And it glows. Interesting. So let's actually see if we can take down this wall with this hammer. Nice. Okay. 6 hits left. 5 hits left. I'm seeing something through it already. Where are we? Here we go. 3 hits left. 2 hits left. And it's gone. Perfect. Let's get out the torch, because I'd like it to be a little bit warmer, and there is an artifact through here. Anything else? Anything else? No. Okay, cool. What's this? Lost artifact, Sedation of Death, upgrades all resistances. Cool. Okay. So, I am going to go head back to the surface. Remember, there is one more in that narrow passage. I think that's what it's actually called, is the narrow passage. I will go and see you guys there. Alright, so here we are. We are back in the narrow passageway, and here is this weak wall. Let's get the hammer out. Let's perch ourselves on this little girder, I guess, and let's just start hammering away. Where are we? Entirely helpful. There we go. Okay. Sure. Go back over here. Oh, there's one over there. Kind of want to be very careful not to fall. And in fact, just in case, right? Just in case. Okay, let's just take a little hop, skip, and a fall down here. There's a plaque, so let's just... there's nothing down here? Oh, we kind of... okay. There we go. Let's go down. Flashlight. I kind of want the flashlight. Okay, what does it say? The five sons, one of one. Akan's 5 sons revolted, struck they were by the Sky Ones, banished were their bodies, we hid them here. Really? Interesting. 1, 2, 3, 4, and then 5, and the 5th one is open. Okay, and what's this? First of all, where is this? That is not a place we've seen yet. Huh. Relic of Life, max health plus 25. Cool. Can we? No? No. It feels like I should be able to open this up. Huh. Okay. Like a platform down there. I'm seeing a cart, I'm seeing some sort of tablet, and then a mechanism as well. Maybe the mechanism opens this. Okay, who knows? We'll find out later on, I'm sure. In the meantime, I will see you guys when I get back out of this cave. Alright, hey guys, so we are back in the cave, actually. As you can see, I put the little boombox next to Yuri's body. We have a couple of bottles of water extra. We have a few med kits now. We have some of this food. We then picked up also some more alien or strange food in the catacombs when we were down there. This time, I think, now that we've done all the weak wall stuff, let's go install the electronics and these tower parts that we found. And let's just go and see where that where that takes us. So, I have some food, I have some water, I have our torch, I have some alien food and, you know, various vegetables. Let's just go ahead and strike out on our own. It doesn't seem like it's particularly terrible weather, and as we know, this place can really close in on you very quickly. So, out of an abundance of caution, first things first, we'll put our teleporter there in case, you know, we get caught out or something. It is very cold, even with the torch, but that's fine. I'm hearing an SOS from the beacon. I'm assuming that's where we gotta go install. Easy. Yeah, it's right over there, I guess. Okay, let's... Remember, there is a way of getting up here without having to go all the way around like Yuri marked off, and I think this is probably, like, it. Okay, let's see. Let's make sure. These rocks may be a little slippery from frost. Oop, there we go. Scramble up the rocks, come on. Perfect. Right? Because this is, yes, this is the crash area where we looted all of that stuff before, and I think we can probably bow out, or, you know, hook around and get back to the place where we have to install all those electronics. The forward vector is where it marks off. So, yeah, there's a, I mean, look at that. There's a lot of pings here. I know. I'm aware. You guys are basically pinging out SOS. Dot, 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 dash, 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 dot, dot, dot. Yes, yes, yes. Okay, how much do we have? We have 10 inventory spaces, guys. Plenty, plenty of inventory spaces. Find the comm tower and install the circuit board. Okay, we'll do that in a second. Tower part. We got another. Easy. We got another tower part, so now we have 5 of them. 6 of them. Alright, this thing's pinging at SOS, and I kind of want to install it because it's going to annoy me. Yuri's Diary, 11 of 23. I miss you, Maria. Okay, you know what? No, we're not going to read that right now. Let's just go install this thing right now, right here. Here we go. Will you stop beeping now? Uh-oh. Explore forward. I'm seeing flashes of lightning, which is never good. Okay. I miss you, Maria, but I could never call. We will never see each other again. I watch our old casts over and over during the night, and it's so sad that I freeze inside. Freeze solid and don't want to move ever again. Speaking of freezing solid, yeah, I'm hoping there isn't a tornado in the midst of a snowstorm. Okay, do we install the, build an improvised transmitter to reach the satellite. Right. Let's go and start adding these. Yeah. Let's just start installing them all. I like the music is swelling as we're doing it. Nice. Okay. Energy source 0 of 1. Electronics 1 of 1. That's the circuit board. And we need, like, 9 more parts. Jeez. Crazy. Okay, but that's fine. We can live with that. Let's, we need a little water. Let's go back to that little camp area slash, like, unlimited water and food source area. Because at least, while we're exposed to the elements, we can at least, like, rehydrate and maybe get some more food. Let's go back here. Also, if the weather really does, like, seriously close in on us, we can maybe take shelter within these structures. Excellent.
Operator, cold and wet.
Yeah.
Temperature dropping.
Yeah. There's light in there. How do I get in there? Oh! Oh, cool! I don't know how that happened, but sure. Warmer-ish? No, not really. This is just a light. But, what's this? Key. Heavy. Unlocks things. Objective inventory. Okay. Cool. I guess. What do we got? We got another sponge plant, and we've got these 2 restore packs, right? The alien medkits, basically. Is that it? Is that all we picked up here? Yep. Okay, let's continue on. Come on. Yeah. Let's continue on to the campsite area so that we can get some food and water. And also save. Let's save, because we did a lot of stuff right now.
Operator, cold.
Shh. Relax. Yeah, I hear ya. Okay, we got some food in us. Good. And in theory, should feel make us feel warmer, at least, even if it doesn't actually make us warmer. And we are okay for water and food, and we got 7 hours of sleep under our belts. So, let's think about this logically now. We don't really have a forward vector, because we are being told to explore, and I'm assuming it means, you know, wherever these pings are, we get to pick up some parts for the tower. You know what I just realized is really good about this place? While it's not, like, you can't make a fire here, right? I mean, well, you can make a fire, but it's like, while it's not incredibly warm in here, we have the torch, it keeps us warm. And if the weather really closes in, we can come back here.
Warning.
We have...
Operator, cold and wet.
Easy. We have unlimited food and water. So, instead, let's just drop it here. Because, again, if the weather closes in on us... Come on, thank you. Oh, there we go. Be prepared, is all I can say. Let's. Well, it's not like tornado season right now, and we will hear about... Ah! Did that thing open up the moment we just started plugging stuff in? Because that was not there when I looked at it the first time. Okay, there are structures over here I want to check out, but dang, look at this thing. Is this like what we're slowly building up? Like all these like pieces of debris that we're installing? That's cool. Right? Because we only really ever saw this, and then I think this got put on top of it. Super cool. Okay. Let's quickly follow up. This looks like a little pathway here. Little pathway forks over there. Let's just see what we can find on this edge right here, and at any moment now, yeah, it's not freezing anymore.
Operator, cold and wet.
Shh.
Temperature dropping.
I hear you. Let's... Yeah, see, these are the things we saw. I thought they were like little round domes, but I guess not. Where is that? Oh, wait, no, this isn't what we saw. That's where we are. That's our actual cave. Cool. Okay. We didn't circumnavigate the entire island, did we? Because that's the other debris field that we saw back when we went exploring in that direction. Let's see what else there is. Right, there's an archway. I don't know if we looked into the archway. Okay. What else is there? I mean, either way, we're heading to...
Temperature dropping.
Yeah, okay. We're gonna do this now. Easy. Okay, we're cold and wet. Let's put on the torch and heat ourselves up just a little bit. Right? It is raining through these slats, which is not great. But at least we aren't in the path of this fire rain in theory. Right? Maybe? Kind of? Not raining anymore, anyway. Okay. Good, that cleared up as well. Good. Okay, let's go back out. not without this. Not without doing this first, because this is important. There we go. And since it's not raining, we will have our teleporter handy. In case that lightning isn't going away, instead is moving towards us. Right, that's the ping, and I'm seeing structures there already. Let's do this. Let's just pick up where we were before, which is seeing what we can see from slightly higher vantage points. Okay, we were here. This was the other dog. Alien dog, statue thing, whatever. Okay, two obelisks, cool, which I guess, yeah, see, it leads towards these other two structures. Fine. We were here. Ah, and here is another debris field. Nice, okay, we'll check that out in a minute. It's over here. Over here, okay, so we've seen this, right? Because remember that pyramid right there. And then, right, that debris. I don't know. Whoa, hold on. Check that out. There's something over there, I think. Ooh, it's going in the 90s. Let's do this. Let's check this debris field first, and then we're going to hop over these mountains all the way down over there. That's what we're going to do. See what we can find. 21 of 23, Yuri's diary. As I was deep in thought about my last recording, Casey dropped by and said he was thinking of his family, about his son, what the boy had said or drawn during recordings. His son is almost 13 now. This is a ship of people orphaned and widowed by humanity itself. All right, wait, don't think about it that way. Okay, what do we have? We have another tower part, that's good. I've got a flight recorder, resistance to falling, plus 4%, cool. Another can of food, as if we really need it at this point. Another can of food. 22 of 23, Yuri's diary. I decided to break protocol for our last recordings before landing and let people speak for longer than 10 minutes. I had expected that our PPHQ representatives would object, but they both agreed. Everyone is feeling the strain. Almost there. Yeah. But I think we found his, like, entries saying, you know, oh, it all went wrong and whatever. This is kind of cool. This is where the pipes come from, I guess. Okay, so we're here now. I don't want to be here. I want to go and run along the mountain.
Reminder, your survival is of paramount importance.
Yeah, I hear you.
Existence of mankind.
Thanks, Wilson. Wilson, right. Let's run over there. See? There's that weird little, like, structure-ish thing over there. So let's just run along the mountaintops. And then we'll just, what we'll do is we'll teleport all the way back to where we were inside that little hut with the slats. Okay. No, we clearly didn't go under this, like, archway. But what's on here? Is this the one? Yeah, see, that's the double arch, the double doorways. And then there are these. They are bubbles, or they're like balls or something. Weird. I gotta check these out. Right? Yeah. Sun's going down. Let's go and make this run final here. And we should get some water after this. And food, which is good that we're teleporting all the way back. I say, without really knowing whether or not we're gonna use our teleporter here now. But we're not. We've managed to run across the surface, which is good. Is this? Hopefully that little plaque will explain things. Ooh. Nice. And we're back to cloudy skies. Great, which means we're going to get some rain overnight, I feel like. Aubali, one of one. Here lies Aubali. Gentle guest from a faraway world. Loved by all, he died in peace. Interesting. Relic of Night, resistance to hyperthermia. Thank you. Hey, this guy's different. Wait a minute. First of all, notice he's got four arms, in addition to the legs, obviously. But his skull is also different. Oh, Bali, what are you? You're not one of these guys. Holy moly. Okay. Bit of a mystery. Before we head back, and I will head back, I just kind of want to see. A little over the edge, a little? Okay. We do have to check that out. I am very curious about what that is. I don't want to see it up close. And there looks like another structure over there. All right, let's go back. All right, we are here. Good. Let's go get some food, some water. And you know what? Let's take a nap. There's no reason not to, right? Because we've got unlimited food and water. We'll just have our torch. Save first and foremost. Right, water everywhere, and quite a lot to drink. Okay, so we have 4 hours of sleep under our belt. Let's sleep for a good 7. That'll put us at 11 hours total. Hopefully we will have slept past the night at that point, or at least be in the tail end of the night. Okay, we are definitely still midnight, or in the middle of the night, but...
Sleep quality good.
Oh, the sun is just setting. Weird. That's fine, that's perfectly fine. So, let's go check out those structures. And as always, let's just put this somewhere safe. Somewhere safe. We can always run over there if we need to. But the structures are, like, in this direction. Do we want to take up quick... No, because if there's another thing in the structures, I just want to be able to pick up all the tower parts without having to go load them one by one, right? So here are the structures that we saw. Let's go over and check them out. There, I gotta say, I'm continuously impressed, first off, by the imagination behind this game. The hell? You guys see that? These guys, let's just pick these. Somebody's like throwing them around. It almost seemed like this one was like landing from out of here or something. Weird. Or maybe they're like... Oh, it's that thing that made a noise. It made a noise like something scurrying around. Jeez. Alright, is there a weak wall, maybe? How do we get in here? Hello. Milestone 2 of 2. Crossing of roads. Mechanism requires a key. Oh, we got a key. Well, before we use that key, though... Is there maybe... Do we need that key? We go up top? Ooh. I mean, I know we have it there for safety, but it's fine. I'm gonna take the risk. Let's go up here. No? No, but these are slats, and there is something that leads down, definitely. Interesting. I don't think the same thing applies here. Let's see what's down there first. Okay. No, I think there's just stuff in there, but can we go... Yeah, we can totally go in through the roof. Okay. Yep, we're in. Cool. Get the torch. Let's see. 21 of 24. Let's get this food. I'm just gonna take everything. Ooh. Nordic helm. Let's read this first, before we start yanking all this stuff. Here. The blue one. Brought upon us by the Sky Ones made of metal he was, stories of his home in fields of blue he carried. Killed himself he did. This is like a Viking helm. Did they abduct like a Viking and just bring him here? Dang, okay. The fields of blue, you said? Stories of home in fields of blue. No idea. What is this? Relic of aqua, resistance to dehydration. Thank you. Okay, let's get out of here and go use the key, I guess. Whoops. Get me out of here. Thank you. Okay, let's go back. Let's use the key and see where that takes us. Hopefully not too far away because... I mean, we have food, we have water. We got more food than I can shake a stick at, which is fine. And I think the vegetables also rehydrate us. But I kind of just don't want to go too far away. Okay, the key. Nice. Crossing of roads 2. Cool. All right. Let's torch so we get a little warmer. Yeah, it does look like it goes far down. Oh, you know what? You know what I'm thinking? Maybe, remember we saw something in the narrow passageway? Maybe this will lead us to it. Although this music does not bring me hope. Yeah, there's plenty of heat down here. And a save shrine. Thank you. Save shrine. Hello. Um, I'm assuming that's probably weak walls. So let's do this. We'll read this in a second. Another vegetable. Thank you. We now have a bunch of these. And yeah, they do rehydrate us. Perfect. Let's see. This, like, I wonder, this has to be the Adarsum, like, machinery, right? Like, it's their stuff. Oh, what's in the box? Nothing. Another light. Let's see. Oh, and here we go. Okay, so let's do this. Let's read this. I'll break down the walls. Maybe eat one of these things. Pick up the crystal, and then we'll probably call it there. I just want to see what's on the other side of the wall, and then we'll call it quits. Let's see, 1 of 3. 2 of 3. 3 of 3. Okay, perfect. The Enlightened. 1 of 3. Right, so these are like the aristocracy of the people that were brought here. Enlightened are the three who follow the holy light of the Sky Ones, unlike the heretic faithless rebels who are forsaken. Uh-huh. The Enlightened 2 of 3. Enlightened of the center is Utuku. Enlightened of wind is Marduk. Enlightened of light is and sound is Kur. Now, didn't Utuku go crazy and, like, attack one of Adarsum's brothers, I think? Didn't we read that? Interesting. The Enlightened. Right, so these three, I don't know what that thing is. We saw one of the Adarsum guys holding it. And these, I guess, are just, like, scepters. Interesting. All right, let's do the following. I'm going to eat one of these vegetables. Thank you. I am going to then take out my hammer. I'm going to take this crystal, and bam, 2, 3, yeah, see, this is what we were seeing through the slats, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8, perfect. Flashlight, very rare, recharges in the sun, ah, so that's why we're still at 89%, even though we should be like over 100. Cool. Okay, let's read all this. Well, the heck, the heck with calling it. Easy. Yeah, see, we were like up there. We were up there. Lightning. Tunnels. Interesting. Oh, hello. Nope, it's not happening. Okay. Fine. It's also 17 degrees now. Jeez. Okay, we'll take that. Another vegetable. Alright, let's read these first, then we'll go from there, okay? 1 of 1, milestone. Moment of light. And milestone of 1 of 1. Heights of oscillation. Interesting. Well, we can only really go in that direction after this, huh? Alright, Heights of Oscillation, 1 of 1. Utuku. I, Utuku, saw the great Adarsum stand tall astride the land as if it were a horse. He spoke to the wind, and the wind spoke back. It made the mountains move. Okay, so... Maybe the seismic activity is based on whatever. Okay, fine. Moment of Light, 1 of 1. Utuku. I, Utuku, saw Adarsum take the lightning in his palm. A river of power cast forth from his fingers and flowed across the land. Uh-huh. Okay, well, let's go back to this little save shrine back here. Thank God this didn't close up. I'm going to save the game here. We are going to pick up exactly where we left off, i.e. from here. Because we have water, we have food... Our inventory's full, which is not great, but that's fine. We can always clear it up by eating these things. And yeah. We'll come back, we will see what's through these doorways, and maybe there's going to be a way of getting rid of... I mean, that's clearly ice right there. Maybe there's going to be a way of getting rid of the ice. And we'll see. Alright, pretty exciting stuff. If you guys enjoyed this, like, comment, subscribe, tell a friend. Lets me know that I'm doing something right. Lets me know that you guys want to see more of this stuff. If you have thoughts on the game, you think I'm overlooking something, you have ideas about what's happening in terms of the story, or where it's going to go from here, by all means, leave a comment. Everything's welcome, and in any case, I'll see you all next time. Ba-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-